छेल छबीली, कहते हैं मुझको रास रसीली।
I'm Chitranjan Singh hai aur main India pada hua tha aur New Delhi ke paas village mein. My name is Chitranjan Singh. I was born in a village in New Delhi in India.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and base this interview off the Geiger and David Heiser's transcultural assessment model. Okay, so I'm going to ask you a few questions and then you can just give me a brief response on them. So if you've noticed when he spoke in his language, it's a very strong language. It's not... it's often taken as arguments or things like that, but it's just the way of communication. They use a lot of hand movement and head movement to communicate. Now, what's your depiction on touch?
Guy to guy is okay, but guy to girl is not okay at all. It's very inappropriate.
Okay. Now, as far as space, what is your degree of comfort?
With the strangers, is about 18 inches to 3 feet, mm-hmm. And with the family, is totally fine.
Okay. Now, is this uncomfortable about how close we are?
A little bit. Not that much, though, yeah.
Okay. Well, now what about with family?
Family's okay.
Are they as close as you want?
As close as you want, yes.
Okay. Now, from what I understand, when you're saying hi to family, you touch their feet, correct?
Yes, to only to the elders.
Okay. For what?
It's just trying to get their blessing, and it's really respectful.
Sign of respect.
Yes.
Okay. Now we're gonna talk about your social organization. So your normal state of health would be good to excellent.
Yes.
Okay.
Great.
All right. Any children?
No, not yet.
Your marital status?
Still single.
Okay. Your parents, are they living or deceased?
They're living.
Both?
Both of them, yes.
Okay. Now, what do you define as social activity? Or what are some activities you enjoy or hobbies?
In India, cricket. Cricket is our main sport, and we enjoy playing cricket and riding bikes. That was our hobbies.
So you're not even playing video games like America?
No, definitely not, no. Okay. We didn't even have video games when I was growing up.
Okay, do you believe in a supreme being?
Yes, I do. We have a lot of lots of gods.
From
we believe it's Hinduism, and we believe in lots of gods.
Okay, so what is your role in your family? You are the youngest male, so how does your
since I'm the male, so I am the protector of the house, no matter what.
Okay, now what does work mean to you?
Work is everything because as a farmer, as I told you, I was born in a village, it's on a farm, and as a farmer, all we do is work every single day. We don't have any days off because every single day we have to water the plants and all that stuff.
And tend to the animals.
Yes.
Okay, now we're going to go into time. So would you say that Indians are past, present, or future oriented?
Definitely future oriented, yes.
Okay, now what is your view of time? So... do you go off of clock, or are you more off of social events? How are...
No, we don't really have clocks. So, and in India, we have a lot of time. So it doesn't, we don't really have to be on clock. We just go with the flow, I guess.
And a lot of it's based off of sunrise and
sundown. Sunrise and sundown, yes.
Okay. Now, what kind of, Do you wear a timepiece every day to keep you on track now that you're in America?
Yes, I do. I have a phone and a watch at all times.
Okay, so now if you're going to go to the hospital and you have an appointment at 2 o'clock, what time would you be there?
In America?
Yes.
I'll be there before 2 for sure, yes. About 15 minutes early.
Okay. Now, if you expected a nurse to come out and see you, and they were supposed to be in half an hour, and they were late, how long would you give them before you go and ask them what's going on?
To be honest, about half an hour before I go. Yeah.
So you would expect them to be there on time as well?
Yes.
Okay. Now, we're going to talk about your environmental control. So, are you guys superstitious? Do you guys believe in, like, fate or...
Yes, definitely. We are huge on faith.
Fate.
Fate, yes.
Superstitions.
Yes, we do believe in superstitions. Like black magic and stuff, that's actually was created in India. And I believe in it personally. I do still believe in it. But,
witchcraft, things like that?
Nah, not really. There were some cases out there, but I still in the back of my head, I still believe a little bit in all those, to be honest.
Okay. Now, how often do you guys have visitors at home?
All the time.
All the time. Now, is it acceptable for you to have visitors to just drop in unexpectedly?
Are you talking about America or India?
Either.
In India, they can drop in any time, but here we do want to know ahead of time if they're going to stop by or not.
And what's the reason why?
Because, you know, so to be prepared and, you know,
follow. So in your culture, it's prepare for food, correct?
Yes, definitely, yes.
So the reason why is because you want to prepare
for food, yes. Meals.
Okay. Now, you guys are based off of a lot of home remedies, correct?
Yes, definitely.
Okay, so what is one common home remedy you use?
One of the most common one is anybody's sick, let's say fever, cough, or anything like that. My mom used to give me a milk with ginger, and just drink that at night, and in the morning you're good.
Okay. Now, what is your definition of good health?
As long as you're running around without any pain, to be honest, it's just good health.
So as long as you can work, and
yeah,
you're
as long
good
as you
health.
Work, yeah.
Okay. Now, do you know off the top of your head if Indians are predisposed to any other illnesses, like diabetes, things like that? Is there something you see a lot in India?
Now we started to see a lot of diabetes because we eat a lot of sugar, and but I don't know. Just diabetes is like one of the main ones I see now. Yes.
Okay. Let's see. What is your family's typical behavior when someone is ill?
They will try to do Indian remedy first. Mm-hmm. If that doesn't work, then next thing is the doctors.
How does the doctors work with that?
Doctors, you don't need an appointment or anything. It's for first come, first serve. But usually you do know the doctor of your where you live in a village. In the village, everybody knows the doctor. So you just go in and just, hey, stop by. Hey, you know, this is what's going on. And either he'll go to your house or you'll take him to the office.
Is there any insurance?
No insurance. No, there's no insurance. You just pay him at every visit. Yes.
Okay. All right. I think that concludes our interview. Anything else you want to add?
No, I think you asked all the questions. Yes.
Okay. Would you like to say bye in Hindi?
Okay. The बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद और बहुत धन्यवाद interview. Okay.
Thank you.